Robin, are you there?
Hi, my name's Gabe Newell. I'm CEO of Valve. We're the makers of Half-Life 2 and Counter-Strike. And I'm going to be telling you about the Xbox version. So the decision to do an Xbox version was made very early on. Jay Stelly, who headed up development for Half-Life 2, has a console background, so we had it running on the Xbox fairly early. In addition, there are a set of interesting technical challenges. How we do memory management and how we do user handle user interface that are actually sort of interesting across the board, and we always said wanted to tackle those. But the decision to do Xbox was made at the beginning. One thing that we've always felt was really important and has been important for our success has been networking and being a good client of the internet. And until Xbox Live, none of the consoles were able to do that. When you look at the value we created for people, a lot of it was in giving them more content over time. And that's what drove our success in a lot of ways. So now it's the console platforms are being able to do those things and become a lot more attractive for us. I don't find thinking about the platform nearly as useful about the gamer and the game experience. I'm just senior engineer here at Valve and the project lead for Half-Life 2. And today I'm going to talk about how we got all of Half-Life 2 streaming.
dig up the DVD. We're bringing stuff from the DVD and installing it on the hard drive.
My name is Mark Laidlaw, and I'm the writer on Half-Life and Half-Life 2. So I'm here to tell you a little bit about the background of the story. And how we came up with things in the story. Half-Life 2 continues the story of Half-Life 1, but you don't really need to have played Half-Life 1. Even if you played Half-Life 1, you're going to have a lot of questions when you start Half-Life 2. Gordon Freeman is the protagonist, the viewpoint character of the story, and he really starts on the run without a lot of clues about what he's doing and why he's there. This is one of the things we enjoyed playing with in the Half-Life franchise, is letting the player figure out for themselves who they are, what they're doing, why they're there, while these terrible things are happening to them. Well, when we set out to build Half-Life 2, we were in some ways creating the world all over again. Half-Life 1 was so self-contained that you didn't really get a sense of anything outside the confines of the Black Mesa Research Facility, where almost all of that first game took place. we spent a lot of time thinking about the world that was suggested by Half-Life 1, and thinking of ways that could open into a really limitless set of possibilities for future games. We wanted something that we ourselves could explore this universe for a long time, mod authors could come in and pick a corner of it and just develop it, that there are a lot of different threads you could follow, parallel stories.